Hi friends, in this video I am going to talk about a very useful hot topic, vitamin D and sunlight. How to get more vitamin D from the sun? What is the right time of the day to get vitamin D from the sun? How much time you need to spend in the sun? Does your geographical location impact efficacy of getting vitamin D from the sun? And other important related issues. Most people run the risk of being low in vitamin D. This explains why it has become such an important topic. I have been a bit reluctant to bring this video out just because there are a ton of facts and figures and differing opinions and studies. But then I thought it would make a very valuable topic for everybody because good levels of vitamin D in your body will help, number one, absorb calcium and phosphorus, the two important minerals that are critical for maintaining strong and healthy bones. Number two, keep your nerves, muscles and immunity system working properly. Number three, there has been a lot of research lately about the effects of vitamin D deficiency, and they have been linking it to a lot of really very serious health conditions, including osteoporosis, cancer, depression, muscle weakness, and even death. Vitamin D is called the sunshine vitamin, and rightly so, because your body can actually make it in the surface of your skin when it's exposed to sunlight, which is really awesome, right? The sun is probably the most sure natural way to get vitamin D. Yes guys, that's absolutely true. And it's so because very few foods can provide you significant amount of vitamin D. But the thing is, several factors impact how much vitamin D your body can actually make from exposure to the sun, such as time of the day, geographical location, skin color, amount of the time you need to spend in the sun, and of course sunscreen. We will examine all these important factors one by one, but you will need to have some patience and stay with me till the end of this very useful informative video. The first important factor is time of the day. The best times to get sun exposure and more vitamin D are either in the morning hours or during the middle of the day. At noon, you know the sun is at its highest point in the sky, so you don't have much of a shadow. That's the time when the UV rays are the strongest, so you will need less time in the sun to make sufficient amount of vitamin D. But then at these times, you are also likely to burn fastest, as you are exposed to the highest levels of radiation. So 1. Limit the exposures when you are going to be out at such times. Wear a hat, wear some clothes, wear sunscreen and stay hydrated. I will talk more about this important issue later. The second important factor is your skin type and skin color. Pale color skin produces vitamin D more quickly than darker colored skin. So the people with dark skin such as South Asian, African, African Caribbean need to spend longer in the sun than the people with lighter skin to get the same amount of vitamin D. According to the Vitamin D Council, people with light color skin need to spend around 15 minutes in the sun, while people with dark color skin might need an hour or even more, up to 3 hours. This is a major reason why darker skinned people have a higher risk of vitamin D deficiency. For that reason, if you have dark skin, you will need to spend a bit more time in the sun to meet your daily dose of vitamin D. So there is a little bit of personal research for you to do to find out how much time you need to spend in sunshine depending upon your ethnicity, race, skin tone and color. The third important factor is the amount of skin you are going to expose. The more you skin expose, the more vitamin D your body will produce. For example, exposing your back will allow your body to make more vitamin D than just your hands and face. You can wear a tank top or shorts so that more skin area is exposed to the sun. I suggest you wear a hat and sunglasses to protect your face and eyes when your face and head are being exposed to the sun. Fourth important factor is how close or far away you are from the equator. If you are living in the areas farther away from the equator, your skin will produce less vitamin D from the sun. Also in these areas, more of the sun rays, especially UVB rays, are absorbed by Earth's ozone layer. So people who live farther away from the equator usually need to spend more time in the sun to produce enough amount of vitamin D. For example, in the United States, people in the sunnier southern states will find it easier to meet their vitamin D needs with the sun exposure than those in the northern states. This is particularly true in the winter months when the sun is lower in the sky. So you will need to do a bit of your own research and check this out about the place you live in. Fifth important factor is how sunscreen is going to affect your skin's ability to produce vitamin D when exposed to the sun. Many studies support the view that wearing sunscreen will limit your body's ability to make vitamin D from the sun exposure. On the other hand, spending time in the sun without sunscreen can cause sunburn and may contribute to the development of the skin cancer. So you are in a dilemma what to do. You really need to maintain a balance between these two. A practical solution can be to avoid staying in the sun for too long. Instead, try going out without sunscreen for just the first 10 to 30 minutes depending on how sensitive your skin is to sunlight, and apply sunscreen before your skin starts burning. Another important point is if you wear sunscreen, you might have to spend longer in the sunlight for your skin to produce enough amount of vitamin D. Here is a bonus tip for you. Your body can't make vitamin D if you are sitting indoors by a sunny window, because ultraviolet B, that is UVB, the ones your body needs to make vitamin D, can't get through glass. Alright guys, give this video a thumbs up if you find this video informative and valuable. And be sure to subscribe to my channel for new such informative videos every week. Bye bye and see you soon.